Assalamu alaikum and welcome to Future Stars Live on Adai TV. I'm Hossein Zajar and today our topic is cheating, like manipulation wise. So like if you manipulate someone, you maybe like cheat in a test, some examples like that. So that's an example of cheating, what we're going to be talking about today. So I'll start off by introducing my guests.
Assalamu alaikum, my name is Mohsin.
Assalamu alaikum, my name is Misba.
Assalamu alaikum, my name is Zaki.
Assalamu alaikum, my name is Ali.
Assalamu alaikum, my name is Hussein.
Thank you for the introduction. And like we do on every show, some of you the surah and some of you the translation. Mohsin, you're reading surah and Misba, you're doing the translation. So, Misba, you're reading surah and Mohsin, you're doing the translation. So, can we start them off with the salawat? Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ala Muhammad wa ajil farajahum.
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Inna anzalnahu fi laylatil qadr wa ma adraka ma laylatul qadr laylatul qadri khayrun min alf shahr tanazzalul malaikatu warruhu fiha bi izni rabbihim min kulli amr salamun hiya hatta matla'il fajr sadaqallahu al-'aliyyul 'azim.
In the name of Allah, the Beneficent, the Merciful, lo, we revealed it on the night of Par. What is the night of Par? The night of Par is better than 1,000 months. The angels and the spirits descend therein by the permission of their Lord with all the creed. That night is peace until the rising of the dawn. Salawat.
Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ala Muhammad wa ajil farajahum. Thank you for that, Mohsin and Misba. And whenever you're reading a surah, make sure you read the translation as well, so you know how to implement it into your life and history behind it as well. So, what also is happening today? So, whose shahadat is it today, Misba?
It's the shahadat of Imam Naqi.
Yeah, Imam Naqi alayhi salam. And which Imam was Imam Naqi alayhi salam, Zaki? Yeah, the 10th Imam. Imam Ali Naqi was the 10th Imam, and it is his shahadat. And Ali and Zaki will be talking about a little bit about his shahadat as well. We're in this topic. So today, what are we talking about?
Cheating.
So, can you give me an example of cheating? How, Zaki?
Got the answers for the test and you're in school and you got it on your paper and you're cheating by looking at the answers and doing it.
Yeah. So that's the type of cheating, isn't it? So cheating can come in many forms. Yeah, and one cheating that we can all relate to, as we are all in like school, aren't we? Yeah, is Zaki Ali?
Cheating on a test.
Yeah, cheating on a test. So if you're looking on someone else, you're doing something wrong, isn't it? Because you're getting answers from them. Is that allowed to do in Islam?
No.
It is haram to cheat in our religion, isn't it? Yeah, it's a really it's a not a good thing to do. So so if you're like cheating, you're manipulating someone. So like if people do scams to get money, don't they? Yeah, people, that's a type of cheating. It's like scamming to get money. Yeah, that is a haram thing as well. So today we're going to be learning about cheating and how it is haram and a little bit about it as well. So can we have a salawat in honor of the Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam.
Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ala Muhammad wa ajil farajahum.
And can we have another salawat in honor of our holy first Imam, Imam Ali alayhi salam?
Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ala Muhammad wa ajil farajahum.
And a third with our loudest voices in honor of the Imam of our time, Imam Sahib al-Asri wa al-Zaman.
Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ala Muhammad wa ajil farajahum.
So also another thing that we're going to be talking about today, Ali and Zaki are doing, is about which month are we in now?
Rajab.
Yeah, Rajab. So Ali and Zaki will be talking a little bit about that month. But before we go to them, Misba, you got the first thing. So can we start, Misba, off with another loud salawat?
Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ala Muhammad. وعجل فرجهم.
To cheat means to gain something by trickery. Cheating is haram. There are many different ways of cheating. A few examples are A, to hide the defect of a thing one sells to another person, B, to copy someone during an exam, C, to borrow money off a person and then never pay it back, D, to collect money for charity and then spend it on yourself. Salawat.
Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ali Muhammad wa ajil fajr.
Thank you, Ms. Pa. So Ms. Pa is saying cheating is trickery, isn't it? And cheating is gaining from someone else, isn't it? So she talked about a few examples of trick cheating, didn't she? What was the first example? Zaki?
To get money from a person and then never pay them back.
Yeah, that was one of the examples given. So to borrow money from someone. So if someone say for your mom, but some people think some people actually will forget about your mom because people actually when they give money to their children they don't expect it to come back. That's one thing from the parents that parents do that are really good, isn't it? Yeah. So let's say if your friend. He gives you £2. Yeah, then he says, I'll borrow you £2 and then you can pay me back. Yeah, and then you never pay that person back. That's cheating, isn't it? Yeah, it's like you're tricking the person into giving you money, saying that you'll pay them back, but you don't actually pay them back. That is a bad thing, isn't it? Yeah, so what was another example that she gave? Ali?
By cheating in an exam.
Yeah, cheating in a test. So if you look on someone else's paper, that's another type of cheating. And she also gave another example where she said, by selling something and not saying it's defect. That you know what that means? That's, say for you're selling a car, yeah? And sometimes it doesn't start properly and you don't tell that person it doesn't start properly, yeah? That's cheating because you're cheating that person. So you're not telling them about that, and then they buy it, and then they realize it, and then they've been cheating, haven't they? Yeah. And another was another example that she gave. Hussein.
You pretend to raise money for a charity or something, but then you spend that money on yourself.
Yeah, this is a really bad one. When you say that you're raising money for charity and people give you money to raise for charity and then you all spend that money on yourself, that is really bad, isn't it? That's I think one of the worst on the list. So thank you for that, Mispa. So Mohsin, you've got the next thing. So can we start Mohsin off with the loud salawat?
Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ali Muhammad wa ajil farjum.
In English, there is a saying that some people believe in. The end justifies the mean. This means that no matter what you do, it does not matter as long as the result is what you want. In Islam, this is not the case. If you have to do to do something good, it is better not to do the good deed. Salawat.
Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ali Muhammad wa ajil farjum.
Thank you for that, Mohsin. So Mohsin was saying that in English there's a saying that, what was the saying? The end justifies the...
The end justifies the if... It,
the means. Yeah, so this means that whatever you do, yeah, it doesn't matter until you get that end goal and get what you want. So Mohsin was saying in Islam that is not the case, is it? Yeah. So if you have to cheat someone to do a good deed, then it's better not to do that good deed. Do you understand?
Yes.
Yeah. So this is a really important thing. So so what we shouldn't do is if we have to do a bad thing, yeah. To cheat someone to do a good deed, that is a bad thing and we shouldn't do it. Okay, you understood everyone?
Yes.
Yeah. Now what we're gonna what Ali and Zaki are gonna do? Ali and Zaki are gonna teach us a little bit about this month of Rajab. So can we start them off with the loud salawat?
Allah. Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ala Muhammad wa ajil
farajahum.
Importance of the Islamic month of Rajab. The blessed month of Rajab is now upon us. Rajab is a month with blessings beyond our imagination and a month in which du'as are sure to be answered. We must respect this month and busy ourselves in as much ibadat as is possible within our capacity so that we may take advantage of the numerous blessings of this month and so that we may attain the pleasure and the mercy of Allah.
Holy Prophet had said, Rajab is the month of Allah, Shaban is my month of Ramadan, is the month of my followers. Whoever keeps one fast during Rajab becomes entitled to the great pleasure of Allah. The wrath of Allah remains at bay from him and a gate of hell is closed for him.
The Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam has recommended the recitation of an important prayer to be performed on the first Thursday of Rajab, which will give us the following benefits: forgiveness of major sins, safety from troubles of the first night in the grave, and shelter on the day of resurrection after the trumpet is blown.
On the first Rajab was the wiyadat of our fifth Imam Muhammad al-Baqir, born in Medina on the first Rajab 57 Hijrah. He died in Medina on 7th Dhulhijjah 114 Hijrah, at the age of 57 years. Imam Muhammad al-Baqir alayhi salam was said to have high esteemed for his learning and equation, as well as on account of his noble birth.
Imam Baqir was the fifth Imam succeeding his father Zain al-Abidin and succeeded for his son Jafar al-Sadiq. He was the first Imam descended from both grandsons of Muhammad, Hassan ibn Al and Hussein ibn Ali.
Al-Baqir is an abbreviation of Baqir al-Ilm, which means he who opens knowledge, and Al-Baqir is said to have been known for his knowledge according to Ibn Khalid. He received the nickname Al-Baqir due to the ample fund of knowledge of his deen and his enthusiasm to teach others.
However, there could be believed that he was called Al-Baqir because he spit open knowledge, examining its depth. We believe that Baqir al-Ilm was not an ordinary title because it was given to him by our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam.
Imam said our followers are of three kinds: one who follows us but depends on others, one who is like glass involved in his own reflection, but the best are those who are like gold. The more they suffer, the more they shine.
On the third Rajab, which is today, is the shahadat of our 10th Imam Ali Naqi. He was the 10th of the 12 Imams after his father Muhammad al Zawad, Imam Ali Naqvi's mother was a very pious lady who spent her whole life in fasting. The 10th Imam said that his mother was one of the ladies of paradise.
He was born in Medina, 5th Rajab, 214 Hijra, and died in Samarra, Iraq, 3rd Rajab, 254 Hijra, at the age of 40 years. His period of leadership lasted 34 years. Imam Naqvi served the longest period of leadership beside the 12th Imam.
He remained in Medina teaching until the age of 30, when he was summoned to Samarra by the Abbasi Salif al-Mutawakkil. There he was treated roughly by the Caliph and his successors until he was poisoned to intrigue of al-Mutaz, the Abbasid Caliph, and was buried in Samarra.
Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ajil farjuhum.
Ya Abi Ya Naqvi, Ya Abi Ya Naqvi, Ya Abi, how do I give ghusl to your body? 17 years just spent embarking education, 17 years just spent locked up in prison, 17 years of pain, insults and no freedom, 17 years of disrespect from all new ones. Ya Abi Ya Naqvi, Ya Abi Ya Naqvi, Ya Abi, how do I give ghusl to your body? I remember clearly Mutawakkil's reign, how he made you go through so much pain. My dear father, now you lie here all breathless, tell me, how do I go through so much pain? Ya Abi Ya Naqvi, Ya Abi Ya Naqvi, Ya Abi, how do I give ghusl to your body? When Murtaz poison ran through your body, I felt breathless with your jerking before me. Every shake and sob got in me. How satanic and evil could he be? Ya Abi Ya Naqvi, Ya Abi Ya Naqvi, Ya Abi, how do I give ghusl to your body? My tears fall not because you're not with me. These tears remember your love and care for me. How do I keep aside my childhood memories? Your teachings are engraved all over me. Ya Abi Ya Naqvi, Ya Abi Ya Naqvi, Ya Abi, how do I give ghusl to your body? Ya Abi Ya Naqvi, Ya Abi Ya Naqvi, Ya Abi, how do I give ghusl to your body?
Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ala Muhammad wa ajil farjuhum.
Thank you, Ali and Zaki. So they were talking about the also what they were talking about, the month of Rajab, and also who our 10th Imam
Naqvi.
Imam Naqvi alayhi salam, who has passed away on this day. So what did they mention there about Rajab? Can any of you remember? There was one saying of the Holy Prophet that was there as well, wasn't it? And he was talking about that the month of Rajab is what? Can you remember, Misbah?
The month of Rajab is...
Can you remember? It's someone's month.
It's...
Hussein?
Is it the Holy Prophet's month, and then Ramadan is not from his followers?
Not really. He said, the Prophet said that his month was Shaban. You know Shaban? Shaban has a lot of birthdays on that day as well, in that month. So whose month was Rajab? Zaki, do you know?
Rajab was the...
Month of who?
A month of his followers. No, the month of...
Who do you pay to? Who do we pray to?
Allah,
the month of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's why I said if we fast in this month, that the gates of what? Hell are closed. That's a part of what he said there. So this is why it's really good as well. Not, and people also think that because actually Ramadan is coming up, I think it's coming up on the 27th of May as well. So it's a little bit close. So people think that we fast 1 month a year and leave the rest of the year. But the Holy Prophet said it's really it's really important. It's really good if we actually fast in what this month, isn't it?
Yeah, when the other month ends.
So that's really good. It's really good to actually fast in this month, as what the Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam has said. So they also mention about Imam Ali, Imam Naqi alayhi salam. So he was actually you mentioned his date of birth as well, didn't you? Can any of you remember his date of birth? Any of you?
One.
Ali?
Born in Medina on the first Rajab.
Was that for Muhammad Bakr?
No.
Are you sure? Turn off the other page. Might be on there. Can you remember? Any of you remember?
Yeah, he was born in Medina on the fifth Rajab. 214.
Yeah.
Isri.
Yeah, that's why. And then he died on the third Rajab, didn't he?
Yeah.
So thank you for sharing that with us, Ali and Zaki. That's really important on the show because it is relevant as it is the month of Rajab and it is the Shahadat of Imam Naqi alayhi salam. So thank you, Ali and Zaki. So Hussein, you for the next thing. So can we start Hussein off with the last salawat?
Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ala Muhammad wa ajil farjum.
Example: I want to donate some money to the mosque. Now, if I go around telling people that I am in hardship and that I need money, and I donate the money which I am given to the mosque, will I get sawab? The answer is no. Instead of getting sawab, I will get guna, sins for cheating the people. One thing about cheating is that no matter how many people you cheat or how well you can cheat, you can never cheat yourself or Allah. If you are cheating someone, your conscience, the positive aspect of the nafs, will realize immediately. So what?
Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ala Muhammad wa ajil farjum.
Thank you, Sam. So Sam was mentioning there that if you say if you are giving what charity to the mosque, Hussein?
If you are trying to get money for a charity to give to the mosque,
Misbah?
If you try to get money to donate to the mosque, but say that to the people that you're in hardship, you will get swab and it was no that you won't.
Yeah, I was saying if you're gonna Muslim, what was you saying?
I want to say that because you tell people in the mosque that you're having a hardship and then the money that you give them, you donate it back to them.
Is that right, Mohsin?
No.
Are you sure that was right, Zaki?
He was saying if you said you were in hardship and you need money and but you were getting money to donate to the mosque, you won't get sawab because you're cheating on the people that gave you the money for you, not for the charity of the mosque. So you're not gonna get sawab. You're not gonna get blessings because you cheated. You're gonna get guna for cheating on the people that gave you the money.
Yeah, that's right. So what is it? So it's actually saying that if you say that you're giving money to the mosque and then you tell people that you're having hardships, that actually you won't get sawab, you're actually getting guna because you're cheating the people. And what did he say? That you can't cheat who? Allah and yourself. And what was he saying?
And it's basically like doing a bad deed just to do a good deed. So you're having to go to, like, going to do something wrong just to do something good.
That's right. So, Zaki, what were you saying?
Also, because you're doing a bad deed to do a good deed, so it's better not to do the thing anyway, so you don't so it's not so it's better to not do the good deed anyway.
Yeah, that's right. So thank you for explaining that. So Hussein, what number were we on?
Number five.
Yeah, so can we start? Mohsin Hafiz Al-Aus Salawat. Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ala Muhammad wa ajil farajahum.
The reason why is cheating is haram, because one, you are gaining something at someone else's expense, and two, you are gaining something without working for it. Islam is strict on justice. If you are here to get something good, it must be through your own deeds and not through someone else's. Salawat.
Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ali Muhammad wa ajil farajahum.
Thank you, Mohsin. So Mohsin was explaining there that cheating is haram because it's going by the expense of someone else. So so if we go back to the test example, like if you're copying someone from a test, what are you getting there? Ali, what are you getting there? And
answers.
Yeah, you're getting their answers. So when you copy someone from a test, so you're sitting down, you're doing the test, you're stuck on one question, and you go over, look, and you get the answer, and you get their answer from it, and you write it down. So it's whose answer is it?
Somebody else's.
Yes, someone else's. And you're writing on your test and taking credit for their, what they've done. So that's not justice, is it? Yeah. So even if you think in the head, they could possibly be wrong as well, also, couldn't they?
Yeah,
so you should think for yourself, shouldn't you? Yeah, so you're taking credit for someone else's answer, yeah, for your own benefit. What you're doing, you're getting the answer for your own
benefit.
So this is really bad, because we should, in Islam, we should be what? Zaki?
We shouldn't cheat.
Yeah, we should be just. We should be just and don't cheat people. And doing that, it's not just, is it? You're taking credit for someone else's answer. So Hussein, you've got the next thing. So can we start Hussein off with Allah salawat?
Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ali Muhammad wa ajil farajahum.
This means to cheat someone by committing some type of fraud, or to divert money by deceit for one's own use. This is a very common thing amongst large organizations, especially in the world today, where very few people are guided with moral values. Even in such cases where the person committing the crime is aware of his action and his conscience is warning him of the act, he will silence himself, stub out his conscience by saying that is allowed during business, because business is placed by a different set of rules. So what?
Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ali Muhammad wa ajil farajahum.
I think Hussein actually missed out a word. So what was that word?
Embezzlement.
And that's what is it actually? What does that mean? Yeah, any of you know? Zaki?
Does it mean when you're does it mean when you're taking someone's credit?
Yeah, it's kind of like that. It's when you it's not exactly taking someone's credit. Do any of you else know? You saying?
Is it like when you know you're doing something wrong, but you're trying to? Yeah, your conscience and yourself know that you're doing something wrong, but you're trying to like cheat yourself in a way, like you're trying to think, no, I am doing the right thing.
Not exactly. Exactly. You can say that word properly. What was that word?
Embezzlement.
That actually means when you when from someone else's losses, you gain from that. Yeah? Do you understand?
Yeah.
So from someone else's losses, you gain from that. And what was he saying talking about? What was he saying talking about in that? That is common for?
Common for people to do it.
Yeah, kind of. And from nowadays, from what? What was he saying? From big.
To.
Common. Not
organizations.
Yeah, big organizations, and so some of them actually do this. They gain from people's losses. So this is not a good thing, is it? So Hussein, have you got the next thing as well? So can we start Hussein off with the last salawat?
Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ali Muhammad wa ajil farjahum.
Embezzlement is haram for many reasons, amongst which the unfair gain at someone else's loss is of primary importance. We must always remember, no matter what action we do, Allah is a witness watching over us. We should not commit any unlawful act for a variety of reasons. Some include taqwa, to be ashamed of gaining Allah's displeasurement, and fear of the day of judgment. Allah is not cruel. He will, if He wishes, forgive those sins committed accidentally or repeated for due to His justice. How can we expect forgiveness of those sins we do on purpose against others? So what?
Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ali Muhammad wa ajil
farjahum. Thank you, Hussein. So Hussein was talking about, then he explained a little bit about embezzlement as well. So to gain from other people's losses, and what is he saying? That Allah is always
watching.
Yeah, Allah is always watching. Remember that story that I told you? I think this was ages ago. It's before you actually came on the show, about the squirrels. Oh yeah, you remember that story? Yeah, I won't talk about that story now because it might take a little bit of our time. So in that story, it's talking about that you can never hide from who?
Allah.
Yeah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because he can witness everything. And in that actually story, they gave an example talking about how you cannot hide from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And it actually shows us about how we can't actually hide from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So he's saying that whatever you do, Allah is watching. Yeah, Allah is a witness and He's watching. So you shouldn't be actually doing this. So he's saying that Allah is very forgiving. Yeah, forgiveful. Yeah. So if you, whatever you've done by accident, He'll forgive you and stuff like that. But for things that you know you're doing consciously and you're doing it to at the loss of other people's, that's really bad, isn't it? Yeah, and you're doing purposely time and time over again, will Allah forgive you?
It depends.
No.
So like I'll give you an example. If you're let's say you're a teacher, and then there's one kid that what he does, he always messes around in the class. He always messes around and doing stuff. So you tell him off once. Yeah, and he says, oh, I'm sorry, I won't do it again. And then he keeps doing it. And then you tell him off again, and he says, I won't do it again. But he keeps doing it. What would you do to that? Would you forgive him again?
No.
No, Zaki, what would a teacher do?
A teacher will actually send the child out. But if I was the teacher, I would talk to him and say, why is he doing this?
So that's what a one good teacher. What a teacher would do, they'll start getting angry at this child, wouldn't they? He keeps doing this after they've told them time and time again. She's giving them warnings. He or she has given them warnings, hasn't she? Yeah. And then what do teachers usually do at the end? Give them a, Mohsin, do you know?
Detention.
Yeah, detention. So same with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You keep going back to Him for forgiveness, but you keep doing that thing purposely again, yeah? He'll give you detention, wouldn't He? And where's that detention?
Hell.
Yeah, hell. Hell is that detention. So we don't want to get in that detention, do we?
A lot of detention, you don't want to go in it, so that shows a person doesn't want to get in it, but they do the thing and they know they don't want to go.
Yeah. If you know you don't want to go in there, but you're still doing that thing, that's really bad, isn't it? Yeah, so thank you for that, Hussein. So, Miss Wee, you've got the next thing. So, can we start, Hussein, can we start, Miss Wee, with the last salawat?
Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ala Muhammad wa ajil farajahum.
The Holy Prophet has stated that four types of sins which will bring different calamities are as follows. When people break promises, Allah makes their enemies to rain them. When people go against divine will, poverty is widespread. Immoral deeds are openly lead to deadly diseases increasing. When people show way and cheat, there will be a decrease in livelihood. Salawat.
Allahumma
salli ala Muhammad wa ala Muhammad wa ajil farajahum.
And thank you, Mr. So there, Miss was talking about what? Any of you remember? Lucky? So it's saying something about who said it? It was the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Yeah. And he was saying, can you remember, Miss Wa?
Stating four types of sin.
Yeah, four types of things like linked in with cheating. And only give one example, Miss Wa. That he said. And you remember only one example. Can you give one? Zaki?
To cheat, but you know you're cheating, but doing it over and over.
Yeah. So that's one that he was actually talking about. To cheat and know you're doing it over and over again, but you essentially don't care about it. So that's a really bad thing, isn't it? Yeah. So thank you for that, Misbah. So we've actually today, what will we learn about?
Cheating, and we learned about Imam's and Naki's day when he died.
Yeah.
So we learned about two things: cheating and Imam Naki.
And also
the month of Rajab.
Yeah, the month of Rajab. Yeah. So we should know cheating is a really bad thing, whether in a minor situation like a test, or to a big situation where you're cheating a whole group of people. Like a scamming wise, so they're both haram and they are really both bad. Yeah, so now I've got a little bit of questions for you guys. Yeah, haven't got enough for like all of us to answer like one person. There's only I'll give you like four questions now. Yeah, so out those four questions, some of you might get zero, so you have to quickly put your hand up. So this is actually a test, you ask, because I know all of you know the answer, but you have to quickly put your hand up to get that.
Yeah. That's the thing.
So number one, cheating means to gain something by blank. Hussein?
By trickery.
Yeah, by trickery. Okay, number two, hands down, fully down. I want to see them. Just have them on the your lap.
Okay.
Yeah. So.
Look. I don't
have. It's fine. It's on your lap. Alright. So this example now. True or false? If I steal from the rich and I give it to the poor, then is it counted as cheating? Ali? Yeah.
Yes.
Yes, it is counted as cheating. Counted as cheating. Why do you think it's counted as cheating, Zaki?
Oh, because you're stealing, so that's cheating. You're not using your own money, you're using people's money, so
yeah.
That's stealing. So you're doing another thing wrong, and you're cheating. So that's two things you're doing wrong, and you're giving that to a poor, and then you think you're that's right, but it's not.
Yeah. So even people say. And even our imams, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, that you would get sawab if you give it to someone, but you're doing that thing bad, So what did we talk about before? That if you have to cheat someone to do a good deed, it's what?
You're saying?
It's better not to do
it. Yeah, better not to do it. Same in this situation. If, say for, do you know who Robin Hood is?
Yeah, Robin Hood.
What does he do?
He steals money from the rich and gives it to the poor.
Yeah, so that's cheating, isn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah, so he's robbing other people and giving it to the poor. He's not using his own money, he's robbing from the rich and giving it to the poor. That is cheating and it is a bad thing as well. You're saying?
People should always try to do a good deed, but if it's at the expense of somebody else or you're doing a bad deed just to commit that good deed, you shouldn't do it at all. Basically.
Yeah, that's right. So, okay, and now question number three. Give an example, give a specific example of cheating and how it is wrong. Zaki.
Cheating on a test, basically, you don't know all of it, so you look at someone's LT and you're writing all the answers down, so that's cheating.
Yeah, so why is it wrong?
It's wrong because you're cheating and also you're not thinking for yourself, you're not...
You're using someone else's, aren't you?
Yeah. And there's 50%, it might be wrong. 50%
yeah.
It might be wrong.
Yeah, so that's right. So so far, Hussein's got 1 point, Ali's got 1 point, Zaki's got 1 point.
Two.
You two got a try now. So now, this I've got two more questions. So I actually had five questions. So you three leave out from these two questions. So then we can have one more question. So overall winner, yeah. All right. Why? This is going back to the term that we had near to the beginning of the show. You remember that the end justifies the mean.
Yeah.
Remember that. Yeah. Why doesn't the end justify the mean, Mohsin? Misbah?
It doesn't because
remember what we were talking about? Just even a few in on the last
because
question.
On the
last question, what we were talking about? Think about the last question. It might help you. So why doesn't end justify the mean? Come on. I give you 10 more seconds.
Mean is cheating, then the...
All right, 5, 4, 3,
scamming of
two, one. All right, I'll tell you, so let me come get over the thing. So it actually means that why doesn't the end justify the mean? Because if you're doing something at the start, remember what I said, that if you have to do a bad deed to do a good deed, that's wrong, isn't it? Yeah. So if you do the starting point as a bad deed, then the means at the end is also bad as well. So that's why. All right. Now last question. I'll do it for these three now. So you two, you gotta stay back for this question. So. Number five, in your own words, explain what explain what embezzlement and how does it compare to cheating?
Because embezzlement, I can't say it properly, because embezzlement means when you're scamming, it's like scamming a person,
yeah.
Right?
So what does embezzlement mean?
Embezzlement is similar to scamming, but you're basically doing is cheating. Is that?
Kind of, you're nearly there. I'll give it to you, Sain.
So you're doing something at the expenses of somebody else's. For someone else.
So now, how does that compare to cheating?
Because cheating, one example of cheating is looking at somebody else's test.
Yeah.
You're taking credit for their answers, so that also relates to embezzlement when you're taking something off someone else.
Yeah, so that's right. So at the end of that quiz, Hussein has in first place with 2 points, Ali and Zaki joint second place with 1 point, and sadly, Mohsin and Misbah in last ploy with 0 points. So thank you all for joining me on today's show. Have you learned?
Yes.
A lot of things.
Yes.
And I hope people at home as well has learned a lot of things. So we'll see you next week, same time, same place on Hidayah TV. But until then, good office.